Hi, welcome back to Mechanical Pros. I'm Quentin. Today we're going to be talking about how to connect the Daikin Bluetooth Service Checker. The first thing that you need to understand about the Bluetooth Service Checker is what type of device will you be connecting it to? An iPhone or an iPad or something such as that, or an Android product? The reason being is because they're two totally different part numbers. So whenever you reach out to your Daikin provider, make sure that you tell them what type of device you'll be connecting it to. So the Daikin Bluetooth Service Checker has the ability to connect to a wide range of VRV and Daikin Mini Split products, okay? It's going to be provided with two different cables so that you'll be able to connect to different types of products. So now I'm going to show you an example of how to connect a Bluetooth Service Checker to a Daikin system. This is one of our Daikin VRV systems here in the lab, so it's going to require the larger of the two connectors. So whenever you go to connect your Bluetooth Service Checker, you're going to notice that there's a connector on the side, okay? And then we're going to take our cable, plug it in directly to the side. There's only one way that it can plug in. Then we're going to take the other end of the cable, and on your VRV systems like we have here in our lab, this is a VRV4 system, it's going to be the blue X27A plug, and we're just going to connect like so. Just plug it in, you'll feel it snap, and you'll see the status LED begin to blink. Once you see the blinking light, now you're ready to connect the device to your tablet or phone or whatever it is that you're connecting to. So the first thing that you need to do is enable the Bluetooth function of the device. So we'll go to settings and we're going to enable Bluetooth. So the device name is going to be BTSC. You notice that it's not connected right now. So we're going to go ahead and enable that device. So now it is connected. You will also notice that the light has gone solid. It's no longer flashing. A little message is going to pop up at the top that says Daikin Air Conditioner Monitoring Tool would like to communicate with the Bluetooth Service Checker. We're going to allow that function. Okay? So it's immediately going to boot up the program. So in order to be able to connect your Bluetooth Service Checker to your device, you'll first need to download the app from the App Store or the Google Play Store. Okay, that app is going to be called Daikin AC Monitoring Tool. Okay, and it looks like this. So whenever you get ready to access the program, you simply select the icon. So now that the Daikin program has launched, we will want to physically start looking at some data. So you're going to press the little red circle in the bottom right corner, and it's going to show the devices that are found. Okay, so you see your Bluetooth Service Checker. We're going to go ahead and select that device. So you've got two different options. Either you can record only, which is not really creating a customer database for that particular piece of equipment that you're connected to, or you can go to add new, which is actually going to create a file for the piece of equipment you're connected to. So for today, we're going to go ahead and add new, and then you're going to come up here to customer ID, and in our sake, we're going to put MRG Lab. You can fill out as much or as little information as you like. This is just to help you identify the system that you're looking at, okay? So once you complete all the information that you want to add, you'll click the green check mark, and now it's going to ask for a network map selection. We need to add a new map, so we're going to click Add New. Following this, we need to actually connect to the Bluetooth Service Checker and start recording some data or start attaining some data. So we're going to have the little chain link icon that you see here in the left, and we're going to click it. We have the auto select function enabled, and it's going to take a brief minute for it to detect the equipment it's connecting to. So it shows the quantity of indoor units that it detects on the system. In our case, there's three indoor units. Now we need to select a data label file, okay? So we'll click the unselected tab, and it's going to give a whole host of different unit types. We're going to scroll down until we see VRV4 HR, because we have a VRV4 heat recovery system. You see we got three different options. One unit, two unit, three unit. Okay, so this indicates if you had a master and a sub one or a sub two, that would be three units. In our case, we only have a master module, so we're just going to select one unit because it's only one outdoor unit. Once we select that, we can simply click the green check mark. So now we see our basic data. Okay, this shows the operation mode, outdoor temp, discharge pipe temp, inverter, frequency and things such as that. Then we have our control. Okay, so this is basically going to tell us if there's any type of step down safeties enabled or anything such as that. It's going to tell us our target temperatures. Then we have our sensor tab. That's going to give us all of the temperature sensors that are connected to this outdoor unit. As you can see on your left, there's a OU1. That indicates that this is outdoor unit 1, okay? If we had selected HR2 unit, if we had a multi-module system, we would also see OU2, okay? So OU, outdoor unit. Under the actuator tab, you'll see your electronic expansion valves as well as your solenoid valves. You can see their positions there. And then indoor unit, this is going to present to you all of the indoor unit data. So what I like to do is push the little double arrow button at the bottom, and you can actually see all of this data on the same screen at the same time. This is really handy because you can see the entire system all at one time. It's really convenient. Now, if you have a lot of indoor units, you may have to scroll through the indoor units, but you can see all of the pertinent data on one screen. And so that is really convenient. So let's say that you wanted to record some of this data to review it later, or maybe perhaps even to email it to a customer or one of your colleagues. You've got the little red circle in the bottom. You're going to select that. It's going to give you a warning message. You click yes, and then we can start recording by selecting yes. Okay? In the top left, you're going to see that it's recording. We're going to record a brief period of data, and then for simplicity's sake, we're going to go ahead and stop that data. So to stop recording, you're going to press the stop icon at the bottom. Finish recording, proceed, yes. Now, if you wanted to go back and review that data, you can press the home key at the bottom, and it's going to return you to the main menu. You'll see a play button at the bottom center. There's our data. We'll select it, and then there's the only data that we have from today. And then you'll notice in the top left, it has the date and timestamp as well, okay? And so you can go back through and review that data. So these data points are going to be the same data points that you have on a standard service checker. For a lot of people, this is a great option because it's small, it's compact, the price point is really nice, especially if you're first getting into VRV and mini splits and things such as that. That is nice from the standpoint that you can connect it to various types of equipment, both VRV and mini splits. So that's a brief overview of how to connect and navigate through the Bluetooth Service Checker program. If you have any further questions, please put them below in the comments. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.